We believe very strongly in many of, obviously, the biblical values that we have, but we also realize that without a changed heart, according to 1 Corinthians 2, no one without Christ is going to believe us anyway. And in fact, they're going to think it foolish and not understand. So our purpose is to trust the Lord will bring up and raise up many who will come to faith in Christ, and those who are there would begin to grow. And unlike what they're probably getting in many of their churches, they're going to get an expositional teaching of the Word of God day by day. And I'll share a little bit of that as we talk for a few minutes here.
Jim, Fred Jackson here, reading an article here, which is quoting Sean Lewis, who I guess is your representative in Illinois.
Correct.
Now, you talk about Illinois politics. A lot of different things come to mind. Corruption. Four of the last eight governors elected in the land of Lincoln had ended up in prison, and a few other characters in Illinois politics. When you talk about a mission field and looking at state politics, I have to say that sometimes it might be intimidating. So the people that you have, people like Sean Lewis, have to be really dedicated to that cause. And you mentioned a moment ago, you try to steer away from the political issues of the day. And what your real mission is to get to the hearts of these individuals and introduce them to Jesus Christ.
That's exactly right.
And what has been the response? I noticed with Sean Lewis in Illinois that beyond the legislative members, he actually has a Bible study with Supreme Court justices?
Yes, he does.
That's amazing to me.
Yeah, it is, and especially there. But God is doing interesting things in interesting places. I think we've probably lost the perspective of what God can do in the heart of a man. And I can look at my own life, and you guys can probably look at yours and realize that it was only the intervention of the Holy Spirit into your lives that brought you to faith. Mm-hmm. And I know for me, there was nothing else but that. And so God can move into the lives and interrupt anybody's life with the gospel and faith. But we know in Scripture that faith comes by hearing and hearing by the Word. We know that in Isaiah that God says that His Word won't go forth without accomplishing His purpose. So without that context, I don't think any of us could be doing what we're doing. Our men hand out a Bible study every week to every legislator, whether they want it or not. They get it in their email, and they get it on their desk, personally handed, put on their desk every week by every one of our legislators. Some of our guys are handing out more than 500 copies of their Bible studies every week while their session is in place. And they're getting remarkable results. And the ministry isn't just to the elected officials, because it overflows to their staff and to lobbyists and to sergeant of arms people in the capitals. And basically our guys become the pastor on site, the minister on site to everybody that's under that roof. And that's why capital is spelled with an O in our name, because it refers to the community of the capital building and those who are part of it.
Jim, one of the things, and Fred mentioned an article, this is an article from Citizen Magazine about your organization, your ministry. One of the things I thought was just a great perspective. It was in discussing with some of your, one of your representatives, maybe in Georgia. And the thing that stood out to me was that the men and women who serve in state legislatures, in the capital of these states, are constantly bombarded by people coming to them wanting something from them, and always wanting, we want something from them. We want a law passed. We want money. We want this measure. And yet the perspective of your ministry is you go to these men and women who are serving in the state capitals and say, how can we serve you? That must be something that is just a radically different approach. And how does it affect the way you're received by these men and women? Does it open doors, open hearts to have someone come and say, what can we do for you?
Well, I think that obviously allows us to have access, but it still takes time. In fact, our state minister from Georgia, Ron Bogalke, that you mentioned, we just had a long talk the other day, and he was talking about the one time when I told him that it would take about 3 years to be trusted, to be fully trusted in the Capitol building. And he told me that he's in his fourth year, third year, really, in fact, being there. And he said that's proven this year to be true. He can't keep up with the good responses and the people. And so you're right. I mean, there's nobody else there that has any. They may say that they have another motive, but bottom line is they want something. They want the passing of a bill. They want a good word for this, or they want something for that. And what's happening is we've seen our ministries just compoundly explode every 2 years, every time there's an election in a Capitol building, because what happens is that there may even be some believers there when we show up, but they've already had an agenda, and they already have a schedule that they're used to. So finding a time for the Bible studies, a time to just get extra, just fellowship time with them is hard. But when new people come in, their peers tell them that this is what we do at this particular time of the week. And the new folks come in and they think, oh, well, this is what we do. So that becomes a habit. So as the years multiply, we see this ministry just expound. And North Carolina is an example. The members there range anywhere from 20 to 40 who come out for Bible study every week, and that's a phenomenal number out of 170 total there. So we're seeing this grow, and it all has to do with the fact that we're there to serve. It's interesting because folks will come who don't come to anything we do, but all of a sudden the wife has cancer, or there's trouble in a marriage, or there's this, and they're even embarrassed to take it back to their own pastor or priest if they have them back home. But they'll bring it to our guys, and therefore the counseling ministry becomes significant. Many of our guys have seminary degrees. Some of them graduated from the master's seminary in California. That's a part of John MacArthur's church there, the Grace Community Church, and some of them from other places. But then some of them have no formal training, but they've been involved with the Navigators, or they've come out of ministries like that. So all of the guys write their own studies every week and print them, and they're online. And we desire, I've told our guys that every time somebody sees them, they ought to be thinking about the Word of God, because that's what that man is going to be presenting them with in one way or another.
Jim, has there been any pushback from groups like the ACLU or Freedom From Religion Foundation, those types who always seem to want to insert themselves that somehow the taxpayers, the public, is being jeopardized by these Christians on the scene?
You know, no, we haven't had very much. We're recently getting a little bit relating to a few of the fundraising things we do, which are banquets and golf tournaments. And when a legislator endorses that, then people feel like, you know, they're getting strong-armed to support this ministry. And, you know, golfing for Jesus or something like that, they'll come up with some bizarre statement. but it's kind of normal, and the legislators who get the bounce back from it are used to it, because they get it a lot, especially if they're outspoken with their faith. Mm. I think that the neat opportunity we have is being able to minister in the lives of many who I would call cultural Christians, like I was for many years until I was 32 years old. Mm. You know, they think they're Christians. I thought I was a Christian because I was born in America and I wasn't Jewish. Mm. You know, but for the first time, they're seeing the Word of God in front of them. And when you see eyeballs just open up and people say, wow, I never saw that before, they're just shocked.
We've been talking to Jim Young, who's president and director of Capitol Commission, which is a Christian ministry to state legislators. Jim, how can people find your ministry? What's your website?
It's capitolcom.org, CAPITOLCOM.org. But if I got one more minute, I want to tell you guys about real quick.
We've only got about 15 seconds or so, Jim.
Okay, go to pray1tim2.org. Bray, onetim2.org.
Okay.
And that is a website for all of the United States, live, every state, opportunities to pray for legislators.
We've got to let you go. Thanks so much for what you're doing, and thanks for being on the show. Folks, we'll be back after the break. Join us.